There are a lot of disturbing developments unfolding today. Officials now say, for example, that the Dayton gunman was obsessed with mass shootings. And the shooting, by the way, a week earlier in Gilroy, California, is also now being investigated as another incident of domestic terrorism. In Gilroy, the FBI now says they found a list of nationwide organizations that may have been potential targets, including religious, government, and political institutions, federal buildings, courthouses, and the Garlic Festival. What does all this say? These three mass murders in the last few days, what does this say about our country?
Yeah, Wolf, it says something very dangerous is going on, and it comes from someplace. Let's be blunt about this. Go back 3 or 4 years, we were not having this in this kind of way, one after another. This is directly related to the divisive racist rhetoric of Donald Trump. It's as simple as that.
But as you know, Mayor, there have been, over the last many years, there have been a lot of mass gun shootings in the United States.
Right, but Wolf, the difference here is exactly what you just laid out. Increasingly, what we're seeing is these shootings are motivated by white nationalism, by white supremacy, by an ideology which has its chief spokesman in the White House. And it has to be very clear, you know, when Trump the next day gave his platitudes and acted like we should all love each other after he's done so much to tear us apart, you know, my message is he broke it, he owns it. He created this reality. I understand other people pull the trigger. That's not the point. He normalized hate in America. And it's going to take the people to undo it. We're all going to have to work together to undo it. This is not who we are as Americans.
Well, let's talk about gun control legislation. What is your top priority?
I think right now this Congress needs to come back. This is a moment that must be addressed. I think if they don't come back, there will be tremendous anger among their constituents. I think Mitch McConnell has to finally live up to his constitutional role. He is being called Massacre Mitch right now for a reason, because he literally is refusing to allow pieces of legislation to the floor, even though they have bipartisan support, legislation that would actually start to reduce these dangers to our children, to our seniors. Who's dying in these massacres, these hate-inspired massacres? Look at the ones we've been through. Look at what happened at the Tree of Life Synagogue in Pittsburgh. Seniors, children, families being massacred because assault rifles are so easy to get, because there's no background checks, because there's no waiting period. The Congress of the United States could address this right now in August. You're actually starting to see some bipartisanship coming from some people. And I give Congressman Pete King credit for speaking up. We need more Republicans to speak up. But unless Mitch McConnell likes that phrase, Massacre Mitch, he has got to bring the Senate back and bring this legislation to the floor.
Do you agree with Beto O'Rourke, who's also running for the Democratic presidential nomination, other El Paso Democrats, for example, that the president should not visit that city tomorrow?
I respect what Representative O'Rourke is saying. He's going through a lot of pain with his community. I know it's an honest feeling, but I have an alternative view of this. I think Donald Trump should have to go see what he created. I think he should have to go see the suffering that he has wrought by bringing racism and division right into the Oval Office. Let's just remember, he started his campaign the first day attacking Mexican Americans. The very first day. And that horrible series of quotes that we just saw earlier on your broadcast, the use of the word invasion, telling the American people that folks who don't look like the majority of Americans are quote unquote invading, which is madness. There are people of all colors, all backgrounds, all faiths in this country. That's been true since the founding of the Republic. That's what the founding fathers understood. You see it in the Constitution. It's right there. That's the kind of country we were meant to be. But Donald Trump has tried to explicitly tell white Americans that folks who don't look like them are a danger. And is it any surprise that some people are picking up a gun and using it when the person who's supposed to be the ultimate voice of American nationhood is aiding and abetting domestic terrorism? That's what's happening right now in America.
A few of your Democratic rivals, including Beto O'Rourke, by the way, have described President Trump as a white supremacist. Do you agree?
Unquestionably. He's someone who, again, first day as a campaign, attacked Mexicans, has of late attacked one after another African-American leader as if it's a sport for him. He attacks immigrants all the time. But then he praises immigrants from European countries as being the kind of people who would contribute. It couldn't be clearer. And look, at this point, there's no more faking it for Donald Trump. Everyone understands that this is a guy who actually is using racism and division for his political ends. He's part of a long tradition of right-wing populist white supremacists who have tried to divide people for political power. But this is a country that won't accept that anymore. And you're going to see a revulsion, including among independents and Republicans. I don't have a doubt in my mind. The fact that his words have now led to this kind of action, this is not America. This is not what we all signed up for. There's plenty of Americans, I would dare say, including even some people who voted for Donald Trump, who are going to say this is absolutely unacceptable. And before him, no, we did not see one after another after another. This was not the way our country was before Donald Trump.